I'm James Chow, and I've lived in China for 20 years, mostly in Beijing, a global capital that fascinates me for its innovation and its history. The Forbidden City, for example, was not only home to the last emperor, but as its name suggests, functioned as a city within a city that ruled an entire nation. But it was much more than even that. Beijing was a nerve center for the original Silk Road that linked people, cultures, and religions, in some cases for the very first time. These important nuances were captured by John Thompson, a photographer born in Scotland who in 1862 began the first of his expeditions to Asia. To put this in context and the magnitude of his pictures, 1862 was a year when the American Civil War was well underway, Victoria reigned as Britain's queen, Otto was deposed as King of Greece, and Vietnam still had an emperor. This was the world of John Thompson, and the first stop on his voyage was Singapore, an island of mostly ethnic Chinese people, which gave him an early idea of the fascinating country he was about to enter and discover. The 1860s was a complex decade in China, a time of revolts, rebellions, and restorations. But instead of a country, Thompson saw a culture and a people. Like this woman in Guangzhou, he draws the eye to the line of her cheekbone, a counterpoint to her jaw, and her fine hair pulled back. In the same province, he photographs a boat worker, off duty but still with her headscarf on, and a bride and groom dressed in their finery against a plain background sheet on their wedding day. Thompson's portrait subjects covered a range of society that included senior ministers in Beijing and even Prince Gong, whose estate covers 60,000 square meters and is an important example of late 18th century architecture. The estate includes courtyards, gardens, a library, and an opera house. It was outdoors where he found a love for the nature and biodiversity of China. This glass negative is unique in that it shows the Jinshan Temple, the only such religious structure to be built on water in China. The original temple was built during the 12th century Song Dynasty and was developed, destroyed by floods, and restored over successive periods. This picture was included in Fuzhou and the River Min. Less than 50 copies were published and sold to expatriates in Fuzhou. The Peabody Essex Museum in the United States holds two of the books in its collection today. They say the original purchasers saw the photographs as a way of sharing their lives with their family and friends back home. On my first visit to Beijing, I went to the Great Wall, a site that inspires awe and wonder. So today, I imagine how John Thompson himself would have felt photographing the Ba Da Ling section of this mighty monument to defense, craftsmanship, and human imagination. Remember, even in the 1860s when Thompson took this picture, the Great Wall was already a historic structure, with the first walls being built in the 7th century BC. And I think that is what Thompson was, not only a photographer, but a traveler who documented important moments at important times when China was to some just a word and a faraway land. My hope is that many years later, his contribution to art and understanding will continue to open our eyes towards all cultures and the people they represent. As for Thompson himself, he died 100 years ago this year. His negatives and photographs are archived in the Wellcome Collection in London. A travelling exhibition of his work has been seen by over 1 million people in cities including Beijing, and a centenary after his death is now in Scotland, where he was born. I am James Chow, you're watching The China Current. Follow us on social media at The China Current.